The technology that we are developing at Nutonomy, it really has its foundation in the work that that Carl and I and other colleagues at MIT and elsewhere have been carrying out over the past, I would say, at least 10 years. Partly at MIT, but also at the SMART and the Singapore MIT Alliance for Research and Technology. We started doing this work at the time of the Dark Urban Challenge, which by now is about 8 years old. So but we keep talking about it, but we had to realize that it's also 8 years in the past. So technology has moved a lot. And I think that our main advantages are really twofold. On one hand, what we have is a technology that allows our cars to behave in a way that automatically or systematically satisfies all the rules of the road. This is something that we did in a very painful way at the time of the Dark Urban Challenge. And at the time, essentially what we had to do is essentially hand code all the different options, all different things that could happen, and what would be the right behavior in all possible situations. This was very painful to, was very painful to write the code, was even more painful to debug the code. Later, we actually figured out how to do that in a systematic way without any need for hand coding. So essentially what we do is we provide the software with a list of rules, and then the software that it runs in the car automatically satisfies all the rules. I think that this is something that is a very powerful, very promising approach, and I think that this is something that is unique to us. Something else that is unique to us is not only the vehicle technology, but I also think the business model, right? So how you will actually operate these vehicles, what kind of service you will provide to the customers, how would you operate the fleet? So we have written some of the seminal papers, we've done some of the seminal research on how would you manage a fleet of autonomous vehicles in such a way that you can provide the quality of service that your customers would expect. And the quality of service that your customer need to be convinced to use your service. For example, what we did is we did like a case study based on data from, like real data from Singapore. And what we saw is that a fleet of about 300,000 vehicles in Singapore could provide everybody in Singapore with the same level of mobility that they enjoy nowadays. How many is 300,000? At the time where we did the study, or at the time where the data in the study refers to, there were about 800,000 vehicles, passenger vehicles in Singapore. So this is actually a reduction of about 60% in the vehicle count. And if you think of it, this is 500,000 cars that you can just, that you will no longer need in Singapore. So you can just sell them to some other country. And 500,000 car means typically 1.5 million parking spots. And this is all space that you can give back to people. And I think that this is something that is clearly very important in a place like Singapore, which is very geographically constrained. But if you think of a lot of the downtown areas in big cities worldwide, getting rid of all the rubber and metal and all the parking spots would actually allow people to get back their cities and enjoy them in a very different way. So I think that there are huge potential also in terms of urban planning, city development, and how people really live the city.